Most grateful for the return of the blade. Now clear up them their shambles, or I'll feed you piecemeal to the rats in the cellar.
I'll thank you to stay your interest in the management of my inn. And mind you stay that night, too. And if there's manners to be taught, I'll be bent to the teaching of them.
Belay your swivel tongue, Purity. It were only befitting to watch over ye as any gentleman would.
Gentleman? Ha! Wipe your chin. It's as greasy as a launching beam, and twice as ugly. Your hide out of here before I lose my temper.
Yes, Mum.
You! Grab these men. They're from Mendoza's crew.
After them, you swabs. To the street. Best you have no part in this.
I'll be bound. It's Dodd Perch.
He mistook the king's pardon for piracy. Slit the rest of his gullet, I says.
Heave him on the table. Lively now.
Lift him.
Now, ain't it a shame to see you in such ill condition, Perch?
Long John, I bring important word to you. I swear.
Give him a drop of rum to warm his belly as he passes. Now, serve up your piece.
We were sailing here to Portobello, aboard the good ship Hope of Bristol, when we were taken by Mendoza.
El Toro, eh?
I killed every able man-jack aboard. And we was bearing Governor Strong's little daughter. Her he's holding for ransom.
Of what concern be the governor's daughter to me?
This stinks of treachery. Why did Mendoza let you live, you scurvy dog?
Throw him out on the cobbles to die.
Aboard were a lad named Jim Hawkins.
Jim Hawkins? Him that was shipmate with me at Treasure Island.
He was foreverlasting talking of you before we was taken.
Be the lad dead by Mendoza's hand.
I know.
not here. Bind his wounds. We'll hear the full of this.
He be carrying now, Long John.
Brethren, strike the anger from your hearts. This poor, misguided sinner has departed into the heaven of Captain Flint. 'Tis no longer befitting for the likes of us to pass judgment on him. He'll be coming face to face with old Flint himself, he will, and be made to give proper accounting for his evil ways. Amen.
We gave chase to the beach. The scum took to their boat.
The very long boat were towed him ashore.
Sailing off to Point where to Cordoba, Mendoza's brig.
You bunglers. They too and dispose of them remains. Lively now.
Bringing cutthroats under our very hatches.
Shiver me, timbers. I'd like to squeeze Mendoza's crazy cheese head off his body.
You informer. This council bait for purity's ears.
I, for one, say this is time to cut and rip.
Cut and rip, says you. As maroon we out a ship like a row of hungry gulls. Not even a bumble to our name.
Well, if I were captain, I'd lay a plan.
One, ambush the first colonial trader what touches shore. Two, order in the dead of night. Three, head for the drift.
And if you're too chicken-hearted for this, I say depose yourself.
Aye, cough up the charts what point the way to the booty.
Whale's bile, that's what you be. How would you pass Mendoza at Broken Finger Point? What be your plan for silencing his guns? And what's your scheme, knothead? And you wish to be captain? Then by thunder, take over, for I'm stepping down. There be your man.
£900,000.
I buried there.
Stay your clothes before you tear the parchment. Where be the medallion? It says here the weight of the gold is shown by the etchings on a medallion.
Do it now.
He's got the medallion, all right.
There, medallion there be, but medallion I ain't got nor knows who has. And now, according to your wishes, I resign. Now, I go to see the governor.
You said it to me.
Old Don's got a plan.
Hold on, John.
There's no need, lad, for you to risk your neck along with mine.
Jeopardy is not only for the captain, but for the whole loyal crew.
Aye.
There.
John Silver and party come to have words with His Excellency Governor Strong.
Silver? And who might that be?
Plain simple John Silver, sir.
Well, simple John Silver. Make off!
I says in we go.
Mind your manners. It ain't our wish to disturb the governor, but to keep our appointment in the proper way.
Here, what this?
Pour the mates! Show no water!
Blast this Mendoza from the seas! He shall feel our steel and rue the day he sighted Portobello. Make ready to sail!
Sir, we stand ready.
Rebooting pirate! I'll show him no quarter whatever! Him nor any other buccaneer that comes to these shores! There'll be nothing but a patch of blood where his ship has been.
But, Henry, what about Elizabeth? She's in his power. What's going to happen to her?
Nothing. If Mendoza doesn't wish to boil in oil.
Son Silver at your service.
And who let you in?
Your guards, Governor. When I explained the urgency of my visit, they kindly stepped aside.
Get out! Ah, the smell's more than I can bear.
Begging your worship's pardon. and your beautiful wife's. Out with thee! Don't you know enough to bathe when you're in the shadow of your betters? Aye, there is a big change in the air now we's gone.
You'll be gone too, you rogue, and I'll have you flogged.
Out, you scum.
Would you draw a seal on a poor cripple? And him what's heard of your daughter's plight and come to help you?
Henry, hear the man. Maybe he can help us.
Begging your pardon, my lady, but might I make so bold as to say you're as wise as you be beautiful?
Stay your filthy tongue.
Pray, speak.
'Tis the hate I have for Mendoza and all his black-hearted ilk what makes me offer you my services.
Why, I have 3 men of war in the harbor with metal enough aboard to swing any popinjay buccaneer.
Popinjay, says you? Well, don't be fooled by his fine feathers and plumage. He may seem a fop, but underneath he's as wily as a vulture. And when the shot and shell cleaves through the planking of his hull and sends his ship down to the bottom with the sharks, your little daughter goes with her.
Henry, he is right.
But knowing it, Orwell, maybe I can devise a plan to save her.
Henry, I beg of you, on our daughter's life.
Mendoza demands 1,000 gold sovereigns to be left at Broken Finger Point before sundown tomorrow. The money is to be buried on the beach with proper markings. No one shall be there when he goes to get it, or he'll slit my daughter's throat.
Aye, he'd cut her pretty throat for certain. Using force be no good, but there is a way.
What?
I'll have to take this here ransom to Broken Finger Point myself. Me being like one of his own, in a manner of speaking, he'll be more willing to parley. You'll get your little daughter back, never fear.
Oh, thank you.
And what will you get?
Satisfaction for doing my duty, sir. Here be the plan. When he's gone, I light fire signals on the beach. 1 fire means he's sailing north, 2 fires south. With this information, you gives chase with your men of war and blast him over the horizon.
And what makes you think I could trust you?
Sir Henry, you have the word of Long John Silver.
Your Excellency, there's merit in this rascal scheme. We could send men to watch him.
Oh, please, Henry.
Very well, Silver. There's no other choice. But mark you well. Should there be any slip because of your doing, you'll feel the hangman's rope.
As your servant, Excellency, might I suggest you fetch the golden sovereigns and I'll be gone. No Mendoza. It ain't natural for El Toro not to be here himself when gold be the prize. Bide here a while till I gives the signal.
What do you want?
Them gold sovereigns.
to pay for the life of the governor's little daughter. I've come to fetch her.
No thanks you'll be getting from Mendoza, what's sworn to take your hide. My advice to you is, turn back.
By your actions ashore, it seem you and Mendoza were not of a mind to share this here ransom gold with your shipmates.
Devil burn you, you want to get squid? I'll heave it to the shore.
Ain't you forgetting, Mr. Boldiggs? I'm now captain here. Clap on sail and look sharp about it. I'll be saving my gabbin for El Toro. Ha-ha! Good evening to we all. Quite a reunion. And the gentleman from the cask and anchor. It warms old heart to be all again.
Cut him down to the deck! Alto!
My compliments to we, El Toro.
This is better than I had ever hoped for.
Put aside that petty pinking thing. Do we think if I didn't hold the trump card, I'd be delivering myself into your hands?
Son of a blundering ox, what did you do?
Aye, you may well ask. I'd be most interested to tell your crew what your trusted partner were proposing to do with that there treasure when I just happened to come across him and them two poor, now-dead seamen he took ashore.
You filthy pig, you'll be shot. Clap him in iron.
Begging your pardon, El Toro, but if you and your crew were to know the true details, would be working the plank for Mr. Boldiggs.
I'll kill you! I'll kill you! He was going to be...
Throw him in chains! I need no suggestions from scum like you!
See ya, Blade! I've come to finish this piddling deal.
You, the governor's runner! I have the gold!
How one small sack of coins can blind a man to real fortunes ashore be beyond me.
What fortunes ashore?
One thing at a time, El Toro. First, you fetch the governor's little girl. Then give me a boat to shore. And look sharp about it.
You filthy dog! While you stand on the deck of my ship, you won't snap your tongue like that.
Let's hear him out.
Nay, I'll be gone.
No. We will go to my cabin.
And most welcome. I hear the good ship Opa Bristol carried some fine kegs in her hold.
See. And little else.
Another bottle, El Toro. My tongue be getting loose enough to tell you my plan.
Swing! Kling, where are you? Curse you, Kling, I'll have you chained to the keel.
What, keep you no cabin, boy, a captain of your position?
I pressed an old good boy into service from the Hope of Bristol. But he is so stupid, the kiss of the rope's end does no more and make him stubborn like the mule. I think I will throw him to the fish.
Oh, 'tis better to use him than drown him. Send for him, I'll handle him.
Ram! Bring that stupid cabin boy.
Si, si, Capitan.
Now that you have suckled like a pig of my hospitality, I would like to hear how you will repay this. You have made great promises.
The promise I made to his excellency was to deliver you safely into his trap. I told him once his little daughter was safe ashore, I'd light signal fires on the beach. One fire to say you were sailing north, two fires south.
You will never live to light those fires.
Now, hear me out, Willie. My plan be to send his warship south while you and me goes north and sacks the king's warehouse.
Oh, you have not changed, Long John Silver. You are still a man of clever schemes.
Ah, fortune rides the shoulders of them what scheme.
Take your hands off me! Let go!
Yeah. Serve your betters!
He'd taken a fancy to the rum himself, the young varmint.
So this is your special way with muchachos, huh?
I'll chip thee in the eye, E.D. But no more of that. Send the boat ashore and light the signal.
Make ready the longboat.
See, Captain.
A double blow for this governor pig.
First he loses daughter, then he loses warehouse.
Well, better to take the young'un ashore. No soldier would dare to fire in the direction of the governor's little girl.
Oh, Long John, mi amigo. Your mother must have been a witch.
Leave the lad to me. He's good to lean on. That's why I brought him along. Now we'd best move quick.
Adelante.
Drop behind. Ah, Jim. 'Tis good to feel your shoulder beneath my hand again. 'Tis a long time since Treasure Island. What's the matter, lad? Cat got your tongue?
You're still a pirate.
Pirate, says you. Why, even with only five toes, I'd cut and rip if it weren't for the little girl.
How can we save her?
Arr, Long John moves in mysterious ways, which you'll soon be seeing. There's something glistening around your neck, lad.
Oh, it's just a medallion. Squire Trelawney gave it to me.
You mean it harks back to our days on Treasure Island? Do it have writing on it? Etching for sword?
Yes.
Me see it, matey. I'll cover it well with my hand so the moon won't strike a glint from it.
What are you up to?
I was resting a bit to catch me breath.
Move ahead where I can keep an eye on you.
Aye.
Long John. Until your dying day, I will be grateful to you. I regret to inform you, this is your dying day.
So you double-cross your trusted partner.
El Toro has no partners.
Your blood shall run on this floor with that of the governor's pigeon and his.
What's left of his scurvy crew goes back aboard his ship.
I see. So you are going to keep the riches of this warehouse for yourself.
You're growing up, El Toro.
And we both know they could hardly accuse me if I were lying here dead on the floor.
Smart as paint, you be.
I promise you, Long John Silver, should you ever venture beyond the breakwater, I will peel your skin like a mango.
You make it sound real appetizing. Get him out of here! El Toro! Ain't you forgetting something? The ransom gold. Here, Batch. You fetch wagons and take this here plunder across the island to Potter a Spanner and wait there for me. We'll trade this here loot for a ship. Marky! There'll be rum in them there casks, but they're for selling, not drinking. And the first man who touches one drop answers to me. And now I go to make a call on His Excellency.
While Mr. Silver fought, he told us to run for our lives.
Blast him, the rogue has turned the trick.
Master Hawkins threw a knife and saved me.
Fine work, lad.
Ha-ha! By the devil's twisted tail, they're safe. This be the lad what deserves the credit. He fought like a tiger. Hawkins, I think you said the name was. Oh, hey.
I just finished telling them that had it not been for you, we'd never have lived to be here.
Ha ha! There's credit enough for all, lad. I've bad news for your excellency. Mendoza, he tricked me and sacked your warehouse.
The warehouse sacked?
Aye, and sack it well he did.
But there was a fortune stored there.
Ah, I know. But I did stay him from getting away with the ransom.
Silver, I know that your way of life is not one to bring riches that last. And so...
Whatever I did from the goodness of my heart. And no money in the world can buy that. However, there is one small favor I be asking.
Name it, Silver, and it's yours.
I've taken a fancy to the lad here. I thought maybe you put him into my care. Would you like that, lad?
Aye.
Should you ask a pardon for some of your deeds? A sack of gold, the rights to my wine cellar, these I could grant with an easy conscience. But as governor, placing in your care a lad of quality, that I cannot grant.
I would like it, sir.
Yes, yes. And at your age, I too played at highwaymen and cutting throats. Nay, lad, you'd best stay here at Government House. You're welcome to see the lad, Silver, as long as he's here, until we put him aboard the next ship bound for England. There's one due the day after tomorrow under a Captain MacDougall. The Thistle, I believe she is.
You mean, sir, I'll be leaving in 2 days?
Aye, and safely too, by gad. My men of war will see to that.
Oh, it breaks my heart to be parted from him. But here, matey, here be a keepsake. 'Tis a shark's tooth from a real live shark and could be hung on a string around your neck. There. Would you be having a keepsake for Long John?
Master Hawkins?
Yes, Miss Elizabeth?
I would be eternally grateful if you would take this as a small token for what I feel I owe you.
I shall always treasure this, Miss Elizabeth. I would like to...
Now, there's a little trinket I'd fancy having.
No. This isn't Christmas, and the hour grows very late. Good night, Mr. Silver. I'll never again believe any stories I hear of you unless they tell of your kindness and generosity.
Good night.
Oh, thank you, Mum.
Your health, Silver.
And most welcome.
Hole have you been dicing this night? And don't be talking back. What a disgraceful looking sight you are. From sun up to sunset, not a sight nor sign of you or your scurvy crew. Have you taken to drinking in other swill pots? Look at the cut of you. Look at the cut of you. Dirt stains on your clothes as though you've been fighting like an ordinary gamecock and rolling in the alleys. Why, the smell of your loan is enough to wrinkle the noses of pigs.
Carbelay, purity.
Belay, indeed. You're not talking to low sailor hands. And don't threaten to clap me in irons or I'll bash you over the head. You be not captain of this inn. Stoking his appetite with me cooking, quenching his thirst with me rum. And have you talked back to me? Never. I tell you, Long John. Oh, why, it'd be beautiful. Oh, Long John, you lover bird. Thinking about your purity every minute of the waking day.
Would it be too much to ask for a small nugget of rum?
Rum? Treachery lurks in your hull at every turn.
Bless your heart. I've been poisoned.
Go on, drink it down.
I've two arrow in a tail to tell for milk.
And what have you been up to this day?
I've done duty for His Excellency, Governor Strong.
Oh, indeed now. In service for His Excellency.
Aye. Mendoza, he had the governor's little daughter, El, for ransom. And 'twas I in person what set her free. The port upon my breath was drunk with His Excellency not 15 minutes past.
Well, now, at Government House?
Aye. And I've been invited back when I choose to see an old friend of mine who be harbored there. Jim Hawkins of Treasure Island.
Jim Hawkins?
Aye. He, too, were aboard the Opa Bristol.
Well, bless me. The lad be here. The very same lad you've been telling me so much about. Oh, I'd love to see him.
My very thought, to bring him to your side. He'd be like a son to you.
Yes, yes, indeed. As I've always wanted. Will you be bringing the lad here?
Well, no. We've run afoul a diplomatic reef.
Yes, and who scuttled our plans?
Governor Strong himself.
Well, he'd be a wise man. That's why he'd be governor.
Are
you such a fool as to expect him to send a lad of quality to follow in the footsteps of an adventurer with no roots? Now, have you ever thought of settling down?
Settling down? Anchored at my time of life?
Aye. You always were a good cook. And to own half a place as respectable as the Cask and Anchor might influence the governor. And in that way, he might grant you custody of your little shipmate. Or, no doubt, the governor thinks it only proper that the poor lad should have a mother and father.
Bellino!
Oh, well, now I'll be making arrangements with the Reverend Monaster in the morning. And this'll be right pretty to wear to the wedding.
My pretty bird, I wouldn't be wearing that around just yet.
All right. I'll be saving it for our first anniversary.
Oh, Lord. Oh. Treasure Island. It points the way to more of Flint's gold still buried there. £900,000.
£900,000?
Aye, lad. Belonging rightfully to you and me. And as soon as a ship be found, we're sailing back to claim it.
Governor Strong will give us a ship.
No. I've made arrangements this very day to buy my own.
When do we leave, Long John?
You come tomorrow to the Cask and Anchor Tavern. But tell no one a word of our plans.
You can trust me.
That be I and Anne who stand in watch. I'd best be off. Now, give me that medallion.
Ahoy. The guards are chasing your friend. Quick, get down while they're gone.
Here, fetch a sheet, lad, and lower me away. Quick now. Here, tie it round there. The medallion. Quick, lad, the medallion.
I'll bring it tomorrow to the Cask and Anchor.
Give me that medallion.
We're partners.
You blasted wharf rat. Mutiny, Willie. You get what Flint gave to hands what went against him. Them that died were the lucky ones.
You dirty pirate! Are you hurt?
Strike me, you're a smart one. Smart as paint, I always said.
night, partner.
Good night, Long John.
Staying home these nights, Bert, huh? Johnny, you're looking well. Good morning, Luke.
Oh! Thief? Now, Purity, that weren't nice. I were only trying to get a drop of rum for a friend of mine who had a bad night.
A very close friend it must be. Come along now.
Take your party notes out of my hand.
A lay. A bar.
Right. Hold your fire.
Blow your rum bubbles into this. You'll be sobering up, you will. So that after the wedding, we can ask the governor for custody of the lad without shame.
Belay the swab.
Indeed.
Rum, give me rum.
After the wedding.
Proprietor, where are you?
Good morning, gentlemen. May I be of service to you?
I'm searching for a man with one leg and another with one eye. They're the leaders of the cutthroats that sacked this man's plantation.
We know they are here. Bring them out.
Oh, a man with one leg and a man with one eye. Here.
We've crossed paths before.
Oh, now you gentlemen seem a little hot and excited. Permit me to buy your morning glass of ale.
Here, you wenches. Give me my crutch.
There now. You must be feeling better, I'm sure.
Thank you for the ale, man. If those heathens should come in here, I want you to let me know.
Oh, indeed, and I will, Sergeant. You heard what the sergeant said. If you or your scurvy mate Pat show your faces on the street, they'll clap you in jail. Now upstairs, I say, and get clean.
Where are you going?
I've arrangements to make with the Reverend Monaster. We've a wedding to go to. Our wedding. Mind you put the padlock on the rum. And no matter what Captain Silver's orders, he gets milk.
And fetch me some rum.
Milk, supper, weaklings. Belay your cackle.
From the cut of your jib, you appear to be a seafaring man. It warms my heart to see a sailor drinking milk instead of rum. I myself have never passed alcohol over my lips, nor let it be issued aboard my ship.
You have a ship?
I'm Captain Asa MacDougall.
Of the Thistle. City down, Captain. I hear tell she be a trim little craft.
The good Lord's blessing has been denied her. I've but few seamen left. The others struck down by scurvy and bedded in the town. I was told I could find some men here that might sign on.
They'll be faint over that. Any hand worthy of his salt be at sea already.
It's a sorry state I'm in. Me commissioned by the governor to take cargo back to England. And hardly enough crew to up anchor.
There may be a way. The plantation workers.
Yokels?
Aye, but they be honest men and willing. And a good captain could soon lick them into shape.
How can anyone get farmhands to go to sea?
It ain't how you get 'em. 'Tis how bad you want 'em. Do you think you could provide such a crew? You have two longboats drawn up on the beach within the hour, and I'll deliver 'em.
The Lord hath provided for one of his flock.
Our men. Now jump quick and get them both.
Aye.
Hey there, Lemmy.
Oi, Captain. You mutinous maggot. I'll milk. Better to be captured. What happened?
The rum.
We'll talk of discipline at a later hour. Now you get a cart and keep under cover.
I shall be back for you shortly, Master Hawkins.
Thank you, Miss Elizabeth.
And give my kind regards to Captain Silver.
I will.
You best be keeping in trust your own, Medallion.
It's our Medallion. We're partners.
Ha my little matey. Ha bless his heart. Now sit you down there. Here, there's some nice cold milk. Now refresh yourself.
Thanks. You promised to tell me the plan, Long John.
Ah, there's time enough for that, lad, when we're aboard the Thistle.
Then you're going back to England?
Aye, lad. Last night you showed me the light. I've made up my mind to go back and stand fair trial at execution dock. And then, if my name be cleared, we'll set sail for Treasure Island again.
Oh, I'm proud of you, Long John. Squire Trelawney will defend you. He'll get you off. You have my word.
Bless his little heart. Here. It says here, proceed to Flint's Face. It fits the map. Sealed in blood, not to breathe a word of our plans to a living soul. We'll take the witness to the bargain along with us. You go say your farewells to the governor, and I'll join you aboard the Thistle within the hour.
Aye, aye, Captain.
What the most beautiful things your eyes have ever seen. Now put them carefully in my room. Mind you don't soil them now. Here you are. Oh, no, this one I'll take care of myself. Oh, don't tell me. I know. This be Jim Hawkins. Oh, we waited a long time for you, lad. Look at him.
Why, he's twice as handsome as you said he was.
care now. He clings to you like pitch, he does. I knew you'd fall in love with him at first sight like a son.
Oh, you're going to like it here in Portobello. When you start going to school and you meet the other fine gentleman that'll be going to school with you.
But,
oh, now have no thoughts of going back to England. Captain Silver and I are working out what's best for you.
But you don't understand.
Oh, indeed, I understand far better than you give me credit for. We'll have something to be teaching you, and you'll have something to teach us, too. Hey, Long John?
But...
Hey, there's no doubt about it, Jim.
Governor Strong's coach for Master Hawkins.
Well, bless me. Royalty calling for him already. Now, mind you stay friends with Miss Elizabeth, too.
Goodbye, Miss Pinker.
You'll call me Purity. Oh, Mother. Bless him. He's the sweetest child I've ever seen. If I lived to be 100, I couldn't be happier than I am right now.
Look, Long John, I'm a bride.
Aye!
Now the Reverend will be here within the hour to discuss the ceremony. And remember what the sergeant said. You don't dare show your face on the streets.
Shiver my timbers! A landlubber I'll never be!
Ahoy, matey! Oh, eating a dry lunch. This be years in the cask. Full, too. Now, I'd be willing to trade it with a thirsty man for a few minutes' visit with my friends inside there.
No visitors. Be gone with you.
That was good rum you made me waste.
Stingley, get it! Here! See that this doesn't slip between your clumsy fingers. Tie it to the bars. Then jump aboard! We're off to sea!
A wedding there will be, a wedding there will be. Hi, oh, the diddly-o, wedding there will be. A wedding there will be, a wedding there will be. Be that you, the Reverend Monaster?
You're the Iron Hand!
Come in, lad. Look at you, why aren't you cleaned up for the wedding?
Silver and his crew have gone to sea.
Oh, they have, have they? Come aboard, your reverence.
Come on, up you go, up you go. Come on, Iron Hand, and you go quick now. Come on, boys. Here, pull me in. Get up, get up. That's it. He'll run away from me, will he? I'll show him. Come on, Ed. Get up. Hurry up. There he goes. I will miss him.
What happened? A one-eyed man struck me with a bottle. They're headed for the harbor.
Goodbye, Jim.
The tide's full and no farmhands.
Oh, no, patience, Captain, patience.
These men are just as eager to get to sea as you are to have them. There be your men.
They don't look like plantation workers to me.
No time for belabouring. Here be your men and here be your cook. And our wisest move be to put to sea. And sharp, too.
Give me that musket. Hold the
in the name of the king. Halt, I say!
Long John, come back! Come back or I'll tear your limb from limb! You'll rue the day your mother ever spawned you! Come back!
There's Silver's crew. More sail. It's an ambush. We shall lose them in Skeleton Reef, then sail for Socorro Island.
Move lively now!
It'd be strange indeed to have the guns of a man of war firing on our side. It took you, lad, to bring the light into my black heart. 'Tis a good feeling knowing I'll be going back to England to save my name. Here, we'd best get to our duties as honest seamen.
Going back to execution, Doc. He'd swing in the air.
And us with him.
But he told us we were bound for Treasure Island.
Ease off.
I've a feeling Captain Silver will change MacDougal's course.
Ha, lad. 'Tis good to feel the roll of a ship again.
That it is.
Now, you best be serving the good captain and his mate. You and me has got to make a right smart impression the first night.
Aye, Long John.
There we go. Ahoy. Here, belay now. The captain be served before the crew in this here galley.
A serving of information where this bumboat is headed is the dish we're hungry for, by thunder. This be time for counsel, or I'm a shark.
Why, you stupid squids. Can't you see with Mendoza playing ducks and drakes with that man of war? Now be our chance to take over this here craft.
And so we thank ye, Lord, for the good food which ye have blessed upon us this day. Amen. Lost your stupid spigot head. Where's the salt?
I'll get it from the galley at once, Captain.
Cutting rib, I say. Slice it through from ear to ear.
Throw him to the sharks.
Many a day since I heard the splash of a body in the briny.
We'll take this slaver away from Captain MacDougall, tear out his pious tongue, and let it flap a sermon in the sun.
If it till the death!
What's the plan, Long John? Simple it be. Tomorrow, when the forenoon watch strikes eight bells and the sun be at its highest, I'll be coming to have a talk polite-like with the captain. While I engages him in the discussion, I puts a hand on the companionway railing. This be the signal for all of you to take over.
Hold fast. And you never learn to knock on the captain's door?
I have something to tell.
Where's the salt?
But there are more important things than salt. Captain, if you'll just listen.
Speak, but it must be important.
First, you'll have to give me your solemn oath that you'll not let any harm befall Captain Silver. I owe him my life.
Captain Silver, the cook?
Promise me there will be no bloodshed. He's a friend of mine.
You have my solemn word.
Long John Silver is a pirate, and all the men that signed on with him are pirates. I plan to mutiny.
Mutiny? We'll cut them down like wheat.
But, Captain, you said there'd be no
bargains you're making.
Hold, Burden. I'll not break faith with the lad. Just when does this mutiny take place, son?
Tomorrow noon, sir. When Long John comes to talk to you, he'll put his hand on the companionway railing. That's the signal.
Forewarned is forearmed.
Remember, you've given your word.
Aye. Charity shall cover the multitude of sins. New Testament, Peter the 4th, 8th verse. You're a good lad to have told me this. Move among them if you can, as though you didn't know. I'm counting on you to play a part on the side of righteousness. They'll rue the day they ever tried to trifle with one who stands in the Lord's shadow.
Aye, Captain.
You deal with the pirates, whelp?
Have plenty of powder and shot for the pistols. And tonight at 7 bells, when it's dark enough, change course north. If I remember rightly, you never were a man that sickened at the sight of blood.
Land ho!
Well, of course. There's no land on the road to England.
Alas.
Ahoy there! Our lad, I missed you in the galley this morning.
I had chores for Captain MacDougall.
Ah, good lad. Stars.
Aye, Silver.
I was thinking we might have a roast this evening from Salt Pork. If I have your permission.
Fast, Silver.
Would you draw arms on me, a poor cook?
Cook? You're a pirate. Strip the weapons from these black sheep and herd them over here.
Hold your tongue!
Ye black sinner, I hope you're ready to meet your maker.
No. You gave me your word.
Ha 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 ha. Captain MacDougall never breaks his vow. I was going to put them ashore on that island and maroon him with the rest.
But that's worse. Ben Gunn was marooned on Treasure Island and he was daft.
Since you know so much about it, you'd better join them. Yeah, little informer.
Please, Long John. If I'd known he was going to do this, I never would have told him. He professed to be a man of the Bible.
Sometimes them what quotes the Bible has less Bible in their hearts than them what don't. But I can say one thing, Farry lad. I admire your honesty.
Over here, lively.
Fate has dealt us a deadly blow. This be Sakaro Island, Mendoza's secret hideout.
Not only marooned, but at the mercy of Mendoza. And him sworn to peel our hides like mangoes.
All because of him.
Yet, belay.
Belay, says he. You may hold us off for a spell, Long John, but he's to die.
That's right, Silver. Rush me, and I'll fire these pistols. And that'll bring Mendoza's men around like a pack of hungry wolves. Then we'll all die. I'll tell you how to live.
Your schemes won't drag you out of this, Silver.
Oh. In a short time, night will fall. Mendoza's crew will be coming ashore to carouse, leaving maybe two hands on watch aboard. Then we'll set fire to that warehouse. While they're fighting the flames, we'll take over the Cordoba. Yeah. How be that for a plan?
Who's to set the fire, Long John?
I'll set the fire.
And then see the hulk of E, no matter how dark it is. Better to send Big Eric with a flag atop of his head.
It needs somebody small.
If it needs somebody small, who could be smaller than him?
Why, you white-livered scum. You'd have a lad do a man's work. I'd go myself.
You lumbering through the bush would be like sending a buffalo.
He's why we're marooned.
I'll go, Captain.
Silver. I pledge on the soul of my madre to catch you, Silver. And when I do, the death you face will make men's blood run cold for 100 years.
Lad, to know you be harboring ill thoughts of me.
You started a mutiny, Long John. Why did you do it?
I were a coward, lad. But how would you feel to be going back to England to stand trial without a farthing to your name? So I figured we'd first sail to Treasure Island and get the gold, using my share to pay for my defense.
Thank you.
I wish I could believe you.
So that's what's eating thee, lad. Ha ha, blessed Sarg. Ahoy there! Patch! Call all hands on deck! Lively now! Stand by to hoist the colors! From now on, this here ship be engaged in honest trading and will be run man of war fashion and sail under true colors. Chill! Fetch out the Union Jack. There, lad. Hoist away, lad. Salute there, salute. Salute, you swab.
Found them on the beach.
Water. Water!
Bert, speak.
We escaped from Silver. He is headed for Treasure Island.
Aye, but our loyalty to you is above all.
It is the duty of all men loyal to El Toro to kill Silver. You have betrayed me.
No. Water. Water!
Take them away and shoot them. And that is what will come to any man who shirks his duty to El Toro.
I thirst for Silver's blood, but we're helpless.
No, mi amigo. El Toro is never helpless. Remember, our other ship is due from Barbados.
Treasure Island, lad. The place what first brought us together. And now we are going back again. You and me. There she be, lad. As quiet and peaceful as a tiger, basking in the sun.
Where be the treasure?
Aye. Let's get our hands on it and begin counting.
Let's have at it, I say. Why, you money grabbers? Ain't you no love in your hearts for the peace and beauty of this here tropical island?
It's like a dream. Quiet. Beautiful. A man might take a mind to spend the rest of his life here.
To the trees! Lively now!
Who's firing upon us?
I say back to the boats, away from this cursed place.
Not while there's gold here.
But Long John, remember the stockade.
Aye, stout and strong she be.
It was that way.
Right, lad. Have your pistols at the ready and follow Jim Harkins. Cover all of me.
Here, you. Get him inside. Lively now.
You fed her over there. Patch, take that loophole. Big Eric, the door. Blast their eyes. Who be on this island?
Aye, and how many strong?
Welcome back to Treasure Island, Long John Silver!
believe.
Israel Hands!
Israel Hands?
Flint's old gunner. You told Squire Trelawney and all of us he was done in aboard the Hispaniola.
I shot him when he tried to kill me with his knife. He's dead.
Twere't no ghost what fired that shot. Here, you. Into the tower and keep me covered whilst I parley with him. Israel! Shipmate!
I knew one day you'd come hobbling back here to fix your talons and the rest of Flint's treasure, John Silver. I've been waiting for you.
It warms me to know you're still alive. Come, join up with us, Israel.
Ha! You've a split tongue, Silver.
If you be dead, it be my duty to rescue ye.
We've got you and your scurvy crew cut off from your shipping supplies. One by one, you'll die.
Up you go, Frogger, but keep low. Flag of truce, Israel! Us be brethren!
Ah, you haven't changed, Silver! A one-legged serpent you were! A one-legged serpent ye are! A one-legged serpent you die!
This stockade be safe shelter, and we've powder and shot enough. We'll anchor here. And before long, he'll come begging to us on his knees.
Hey, you lazy dog. You had to be on guard.
Captain! George is dead.
Angus! What happened here?
There's your way of getting treasure from this accursed island.
Herbally!
I'm not staying here to be cut up piecemeal. Not me. I ain't up for running for it. And then it's with me. Join up.
There, you'd be slaughtered like hogs in springtime.
Don't try to stay us, Long John. We got minds, too, and ways of doing things.
Think twice, lad. Through the door! Down with them windows! Make fast the loopholes! You ain't eating nothing, lad.
How he hated me. I can still see his face.
He won't lay a finger on it. You have my word.
According to forecastle rules, we've had counsel.
Back to your post.
It ain't us what has to rub with Israel hands. It's you. And him.
It were a treacherous deed that made him the devil he is. Why should we all die for it?
And since it's your blood he's thirsting for, why not slip us the medallion?
So, you're standing for captain again, eh, Patch? Medallion you want. Well, medallion you am.
It's Mendoza from the direction of the beach.
Hold the fire. Them men be unarmed.
Thank ye, Long John.
Israel has. Aye. Blind as a bat.
Aye.
But I see everything. Six of you.
Mendoza's closing in.
Seven.
Huh? Trapped like rats in a sinking ship.
And I could save you all. If I wished to do that, and you have my solemn affidavit, you'll go equal shares in the treasure.
Treasure?
Treasure. I'll strike a bargain. Your lives for passage back to England. Land me on the coast of Cornwall, hard by the Benbow Inn, before I pass on my favor to return to a lad by the name of Jim Hawkins, who did me this. Here, you.
What?
You have a bargain. Make haste.
Follow me!
Trip, firearms, and powder!
Where'd you head here? There's a sharp point.
No shelter for them anywhere. A thousand gold doubloons for the man who brings them to me.
Huh? Mind that hole there. Old Bruce stepped into that and broke his leg. At the shooting we did from the screaming of it.
It fair gives me a chill, it do.
He sees more with none than I do with one.
He's gone.
Were a ghost all along.
Hold fast! Flint's face! If those be his eyes, why that be his nose? It says here, from the nose to the toes, points the way to the treasure. From the nose the toes.
Ha-ha!
What's this? Let's run for the boat.
Why, you blind sheep? This is what we're looking for. The gold be there. Can't you see? I'm down
here. Major!
Thank you.
it'll be quick, Jim. Mine was. Does the sight of me eyes sicken you, boy? Is your little heart beating like mine was in the mast that time? Have you ever wondered what it's like not to look at the sand and the sea? Always to wear the cloak of night? You're soon to know, boy!
He took what was mine.
The first man what makes a move can count amongst his treasure a ball from this pistol.
We want no capon now.
We've been through this together. We goes out together. All of us shares equal. Even Jim there. Where be the lad? And his real hands.
Blouse the lad. Blouse him.
Not one doubloon, not one jewel leaves this island till that lad be found.
Looks like he's dead. He's no use to us.
Dead or alive, he is my bait to catch the barracuda called Silver.
Ahoy! Men down there! Set the lad free, and I'll surrender to him.
Show yourself first, Silver.
Long John.
Arr, matey. You're free, lad.
I can't let you do this, Long John. We've got a chance. We can run for it.
There'll be no trickery. I've given my word.
I won't go. They'll kill you.
You'll obey orders.
I refuse. I'm going back.
Now go join the others.
As newborn lambs. Now your legs be as useless as mine.
We finished them. The rest took to the surf.
Tried to reach their boats.
Yeah, and were taken by the sharks.
Parley. El Toro. You pledged to peel my skin from me like a mango. Well, you seem to be the riper of the two. We'll maroon him here. And leave the vultures to do the peeling.
This is now a happy day. Long John Silver, no more go away. He stay here with plenty gold. Eat good food, get fat and old.
We'll be leaving you, gentlemen, to your port and pipes.
A pirate's lot is not a happy one when he's hanging dead. In the noonday.
My friend. Oh, Silver. I've been waiting for an opportunity to thank you for the very generous donation you made to Government House for arming the harbor against Paris.
As an honest citizen with property to protect, it be my duty.
Your health, gentlemen.
And yours, Excellency.
Gentlemen, your attention. The Reverend Manasta has come here to join in holy wedlock his Purity Pinker and the Honorable Long John Silver.
Well,
you old son of a gun.
Tis mutiny.
Miss Pinker, I'm honored to be a witness at your wedding.
Thank you, Your Excellency. There's no one I'd like better. Isn't that right, Long John?
They went that way. Him and Jim.
Not again!